Good morning. We're so happy that you're here. We vlog every day, so if you like this video, we hope you'll return tomorrow. I am waiting outside of my doctor's appointment right now. It's actually a really big day. It's a 39-week appointment. Tomorrow I'll be 39 weeks. As you guys know, we had a C-section scheduled, but the baby has flipped head down, and we were given the decision. Did we want to continue on with the C-section, or did we want to try to just have me go into labor naturally? So today's checkup will basically be the decision maker. But there was one thing I wanted to bring up before I go in. Just overall, that just, I don't know, like my little bit of advice or my bit of, you know, helping me keep a peaceful mind through all of this is that every pregnancy, every delivery, every means of conceiving is different. And we have gotten so much support from all of you, and it's so cool to see how different everybody's experiences have been. And it's comforting just to hear, like, basically any way that this baby arrives, everything will be perfectly fine. I did want to bring up, just as, you know, we are a channel who raises awareness on many things, but particularly women's health and fertility, you know, all of that. We went through all of that with you. I just want to remind you that had we not trusted modern medicine, or had we just waited for the timing to be right, I would not be pregnant right now. We fully trust our doctors. We fully trust ourselves. We will make our decision, what's best for us, moving forward with the delivery and everything that comes with parenthood. And it is hard because we know that putting ourselves out there, you know, it does come with the territory, to receive unsolicited advice. And we know that so much of the advice comes from such a kind place, and we ask for it, and we truly do. We love the conversation we have with you guys. But just remember that even though we are in this wonderful place right now, and that I've had a lovely pregnancy, and we are here, that there is still a sensitivity, and that we are going to do everything that, you know, that feels right for us. And so soon, I mean, hopefully today, we'll have more information about how we're going to move forward. So, very happy day, and I'll update you after my appointment. I'm home. Dunkin' Donuts has kind of, hold on, let me pause, Gilmore Girls. Dunkin' Donuts has kind of become our post OB place.
Can I spill the beans on the plan that we weren't telling people?
Look at my mug. So our plans have changed. So you guys know before, can I talk? I think my brain is a little frazzled, because even I was like trying to explain everything to Peter on the phone, and I was just like taking really long pauses. Okay, enough with the delay. We were supposed to have a C-section Thursday.
This Thursday.
That was
2 days from now. When you're watching this, tomorrow.
Yeah. And so obviously, like, you guys could tell we were getting excited. Also, we were really like planning our days out, planning all of our lasts and things. But since he has flipped down and things are looking good, our doctor and us, like, we got to make the decision. We want to try and have the baby naturally.
Yeah, so now we canceled the C-section, mm-hmm. and the hospital is basically going to call us to figure out a date that we're going to schedule an induction if he doesn't end up coming naturally.
Right. An induction is less invasive than a surgery. Evie wants the Dunkin' Donuts.
She really wants my coffee. She really likes coffee.
An induction is a lot less invasive. And so we'd rather do that safely, but make sure that it doesn't get too big, and that result in a C-section. So it's kind of like this middle ground.
But there's plenty of hoodoo voodoo that we're going to do to hopefully get me.
We went from all this certainty to not so certain, because we could still end up doing a C-section. But right. now it's just like, it's going to be kind of a more short-term, not emergency C-section, but like not as planned C-section if it ends up being, or it naturally happens.
Right.
So we could be at Animal Kingdom this weekend and your water could break.
Yeah. And I was checked and like things, like it doesn't look like I'm in labor at whatsoever.
All. He's cozy.
But he is still head down, which is the big part. Our biggest decision maker was just, this is our first baby, that we will be, you know, delivering. And so we would like to give ourselves the best shot at that before we move on to a C-section if necessary. So that is our plan. And I want to really quick try that spicy donut. I got the ghost pepper donut.
You took a big bite for it to be spicy.
It's strawberry frosting, which is really yummy. It is spicy.
Yeah.
Not too spicy, enjoyably spicy. It's kind of like similar to like the spice level of a cinnamon heart candy.
Yeah.
But there's just like just enough sweetness.
It's cinnamon spice. It's not like.
But it's ghost pepper.
Spice. Yeah.
This little baby is super active today. And I don't know if this dress is the greatest to show it. But I haven't shown on the vlog any sort of belly movement. So maybe I can capture it today. He's. Are you awake, baby? I think I caught it.
This is my new fall thing. Watching this all the time. And this episode's awesome. It's the first snow of the season.
So it's winter.
I'm so excited because I washed this and I can't wait to use it. Also, I love this even though I can't really drink out of it. Too good. And these are the delicious salads that Sarah made. Like the components to, like the meat component, or like the plant-based meat substitute, which is just like deliciousness that we put on these. And this is what we had yesterday for dinner because she made like a bunch of this.
So this is mushrooms, onions. What was that grain?
Quinoa?
No, it was like farro. I don't know what it was. Beans and corn.
So you heat that up and put that on these salads and make a nice taco salad.
Just like normal taco seasoning.
Right, with a dressing that she's making that was delicious yesterday.
It's hummus, garlic, chives, water, and lime juice.
Modern day chef all over here. And then we toss some Fritos on there to spunk it, texture it up. And here is the final product that all assembled, looking delicious.
Okay, Jake Johnson. One of the favorite
I'm
humans.
Fawn Moscato, the People's Warrior, and I'm here with Jen, Rick, and Wilson to help you cast your ballot.
It's Jess.
It's Nick. My name's Winston.
Nobody cares. America, you need to get out and vote.
Early, could be in person,
or by mail.
Many Americans will be filling out their ballots from home.
This is how you do it.
This black or bluey.
That's red, and you're embarrassing me.
Sign your name as it appears on other government-issued documents.
As long as it matches.
Oh, it does.
And last, vote Moscato.
You're not actually running.
This is not what we agree to.
New Girl is the best, and it's been off for a long time, but they love it. They love it so much too.
They love the New Girl too.
The actors and actresses will always.
Jake Johnson, all I want to do is meet you. I want to show you my tattoo that you inspired, and I just sprayed perfume in my eye.
I can taste it.
I can feel it in my eyeballs.
We're going to Michael's to pick up our framed piece, and we're going to Target,
and maybe somewhere to get Sarah's least favorite thing in the entire world, which is my favorite thing.
Not my least favorite thing. I love a good Italian ice.
Hey!
I just like prefer.
Doesn't her hair look luscious today?
I blow dried it.
Wow. Alright, first stop of the night is Michael's. Sarah's in the car talking to her sister, so I actually think the order for this frame isn't her name. Fingers crossed they let me pick it up. I have her ID. I have my ID. Same address. It is actually my debit card that paid for it. So hopefully they should be able to let me take it. But this place also looks, oh wait, no, it's not closed.
So we'll see, but I'm really pumped. This is getting hung tonight, I think. I'm just very excited because it's a beautiful piece. It's freaking stunning. Wait until you get home. Look at this. Look at this. Target. Ready?
Yes, got some last minute things to get. We're gonna do a
couple left. Okay, one of my biggest pet peeves about little boy clothes is that everything has to have an animal on it, apparently, in the world. But this new line just came out from Target, but 12 months is the smallest it comes in. But everything in the store has an animal on it. Even like, oh, this. I was like, look how cute this is. Why is there a little fox on it? Super cute outfit, no need for a fox.
I remember hearing from someone on Instagram that Target has vegan pizza rolls that are 2 for $7. Oh my goodness. You did 2 of each? You're nice. Okay, and Target's kicking up a notch with their plant-based dip.
This one looks really good.
That's typically just in like Trader Joe's.
I know, this is really good brand. So pardon good. The French, but it's a really good brand.
I've never seen those, but they look good.
Where's this from? All right, we're home now. We're supposed to watch a funny movie because, like I said, I got the endorphins going and everything to induce childbirth. But another thing, I'm having flashbacks to our implantation or transfer days because apparently pineapples are known to induce labor. So I'm going to chop this bad boy up.
So we are really bad at Target hauls because I feel like we put stuff away right away.
I hate putting stuff away, so I just get it over.
Right. We got a Coke that's still out. We got Goo Gone because our new little cups had awful adhesive on it. And
they were just terrible.
If, like, if you...
awful.
If I'm ever in a situation where, like, you need to prove that you know me, just know, like, my biggest pet peeve is labels that are still stuck on things, and I just cannot live with that adhesive. I just can't. And then my dearest Angela suggested gum for the hospital for refreshing moments. And a Twix because we are suckers for checkout line fun.
This is what she just realized I have something she can eat that she loves. Mm-hmm. So I have to cut a piece of pineapple. That's Eve reminding you all to have your plan to vote.
Yes. Interrupting my Target haul for good reason. And then the last two things, oh, this one's blended in, are 2 nursing tanks. I am just more of like a modest person. And so I know that in the hospital, I'll be wanting to be covered up, but these will also be good just for home. This one is actually on sale for $10, which was awesome. And then we got these cute little jogger pants for the little nematode.
Other stuff we got were those Morningstar things, which you saw. One of those plant-based cheeses, the brand that we had never tried before. I don't know, we got a lot of stuff and it was not as much money as we expected. It just felt like a very good Target trip. I'm out of breath. I need some pineapple. Gonna have some raspberry leaf tea because that's another thing, which is it's actually the same fertility tea that I drank to prep my lining for embryo transfer. I mean, it all makes sense that it all flows together. Oh, I also got dry shampoo for the hospital. But yeah, more trying to get labor going. You guys have been sending great suggestions on Instagram, so thank you. I think, did you mention we're gonna hang some stuff?
Yeah.
Awesome.
First thing we're hanging is going right there, just past the mobile.
Feels like it's midnight.
Here is this stunning, beautiful piece of art.
Look at
framed
the wooden edge. It matches it perfect.
Wooden edge, a little bit of matting on the outside, and then that silver border on the actual print. Oh, worth every penny.
Yes.
It's beautiful. This will be in our... This is literally going to be in some room of our life forever, I think. Look at that beauty. It looks so good. I can't wait to see it tomorrow morning in sunlight. The cup of joe in my hand. Just imagine me in just like a week and a half. My son won't be sleeping in there, but maybe he'll be sleeping in the Dakotok. and I'll put him there in the morning, and I can just stare at my son.
Don't mind this pillow, it was busted.
Well, I realized I put it up there and she hates that ball. So James's room is really, it's so close to being done.
So close.
Really all we need to do is get the blinds.
No, these are blinds.
Oh yeah, we need the curtains. We need the curtains, and then we have to wait for the frames to arrive for the 7 Disney blueprint.
We haven't even showed those.
We haven't?
No.
Oh, let's just wait now.
We do want some plants in here that we still have to get. And then we have, like, there's, like, the last little bit of artwork that we want to put up on, like, some sort of, like, shelfy thing.
This stuff.
Yeah. So I don't know if it'll go here. I don't know if it'll go there, but we kind of need to just see the blueprints go up, and then we can make that final little call.
Because we also just
put a big plant.
We just put this up too.
Yeah. We're finally settled down. We are going to watch. What is this? Hubie? Hubby?
Hubby? Hubie Halloween.
Hubie Halloween. Adam Sandler's new Halloween Netflix movie. My name's Peter. I'm a Twitter troll.
No, I'm looking at the Avengers, the Marvel cast, the pictures of them doing the, like, town hall with Kamala Harris.
Okay, let's watch this before I fall asleep.
We gotta go to bed. All right, today was Sarah's Uncle Jerry's birthday. Happy birthday, Uncle Jerry. The 20th. Man, Halloween is ever approaching. Ooh, a simple one from the Boy Scout motto. Shout out Ben. You know who I'm talking about. Be prepared.
It's good to be home.
It's good to be home.
She's working. It's 12:30 in the morning.
I'm just trying to get this to work.
But this is the most unreal sight ever. Evers. Excuse me, Eva, you ready for bed? Oh gosh.
We know what our goals are. We know what we hope to accomplish. And believe me, it's the most exciting and challenging assignment we've ever tackled at Walt Disney Productions.